Hello everyone, welcome back to another new video, and you are probably thinking, how can one even force checkmate in an opposite colored bishop endgame, let alone also behind in material? Well, in the following position, it's true that black is up a pawn on d5, but the key thing to note is that the rest of black's pieces are all in the same corner of the board, and white can use this to create a mating net around black's king. The key move is pawn to g4 check, forcing black's king back to h6, where it looks like it is about to escape to g7, and the game would be a draw after that. But white can simply prevent this with the brilliant move king to f6, and now black's problems are clear. If black moves the bishop to h7, bishop to f8 is just a checkmate, and king to h7 would allow bishop to c5, with an accelerated result of what would happen in the main line. So black plays pawn to d4, and now comes the second key move that will decide the game's result, believe it or not. White must play the quiet retreating move bishop to d6, and its strength will be seen moves later. If black now plays king to h7, white can play bishop to f4, and if black tries to hide the king in the corner then move the bishop out, it would allow the devastating bishop to e5. And now bishop to h7 is just met by king takes f7 mate. But what if black just advance the passed pawn with pawn to d3? White can then play g5 d2 g6, taking the h7 square away from black's king, and if this pawn is taken, white's king will regain control of h7 with king takes g6, at the same time mating black's king with the bishop on e5. Finally, king to h7 is just met by bishop takes d4, and after king to h6 bishop to e3 check king to g7 pawn to g5, the result is the same. If the bishop was in front of black's d-pawn, it would give black enough time to get the bishop on g8 out, resulting in just another dead draw. All of this leaves black with the only remaining move pawn to d3 after bishop to d6. But after bishop to f4 check king to h7 pawn to g5, king to h8 allows bishop to e5 then c3, forcing the sacrifice of black's d-pawn, which only delays the inevitable by a few moves before black's king is forced to h8, and after g6 pawn takes g6, white can complete the study on the 12th move with king takes g6 discovered checkmate, a proof that the opposite colored bishop mate can be forced. If you want to see more brilliant chess studies like this, be sure to like and subscribe for more, and I will see you all in my next video. Goodbye.